Maxillary first premolar is the fourth tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDI system is 1, 4 and 2, 4. In universal system is 5 and 12, and in Zsigmondy-Palmer system the tooth number is 4 with appropriate brackets. The term premolar means the tooth which is just anterior to the molars. They have also been called as bicuspids because they have two cusps. Though in case of mandibular premolars, this name becomes a misnomer. The maxillary first premolar develops from four developmental lobes: mesial, buccal, distal and lingual. The buccal lobe forms the buccal cusp, the lingual lobe forms the lingual cusp, mesial lobe the mesial marginal ridge and distal lobe the distal marginal ridge. If we see the morphological changes from incisors to premolars, we see the gradual increase in development of the lingual lobe, from forming a small cingulum in incisors to a larger cingulum in canine, to a lingual cusp smaller than buccal cusp in first premolar, to a lingual cusp equal to buccal cusp in second premolar. Due to these changes, the marginal ridge in anteriors, which is oblique and studied from the lingual aspect, becomes horizontal in posteriors and is studied from the occlusal aspect. Similar transition is seen in mandibular teeth too. Maxillary first premolar has dual function. It assists the canine in tearing with its sharp buccal cusp and also assists molars in grinding by its occlusal surface. The age of eruption of maxillary first premolar is 10 to 11 years. Now coming to measurements. The cervico-incisal length of the crown is 8.5 mm and root length is 14 mm. Mesiodistal diameter of the crown at level of contact area is 7 mm and at cervix is 5 mm. Labiolingual diameter of the crown at height of contour is 9 mm and at cervix is 8 mm. The cervical line from the mesial aspect has a curvature of 1 mm and from the distal aspect it is flat. The morphology of the tooth is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the first aspect, the buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown from the buccal aspect is trapezoidal with its longer parallel side towards the cusp and shorter side towards the cervix. Only the buccal cusp is visible from this aspect as the smaller lingual cusp hides behind it. The buccal cusp is not on the midline axis of the tooth but is slightly distal to it. Two cuspal slopes are seen. Mesiobuccal cuspal slope running from the cusp tip to the mesial contact area and distobuccal cuspal slope running from the cusp tip to the distal contact area. Mesiobuccal cuspal slope is longer than the distobuccal cuspal slope. Both contact areas of the tooth are at middle third. The mesial contact area by which the tooth contacts the canine is at the center of the middle third, and the distal contact area by which the tooth contacts the second premolar is slightly occlusal to the center of the middle third. The mesial outline running from the contact area to the cervix is slightly more concave than the distal outline. The cervical line is convex and the convexity is towards the root. The buccal surface of the crown is smooth and prominently convex due to the presence of the buccal ridge which runs from the buccal cusp tip to the cervical line. Slight developmental depressions are seen mesial and distal to the buccal ridge, demarcating the developmental lobes. Only the buccal root is visible from this aspect, which is smooth and tapering. Coming to the lingual aspect, as the lingual cusp is shorter and narrower, all the features of the outline form from the buccal aspect are same in the lingual aspect as well. Few additional features seen from this aspect are: both the cusps are visible as the lingual cusp is smaller but sharp with its cuspal slope meeting at right angle. As the lingual cusp is narrower, more portion of the proximal surfaces are seen from this aspect. A lingual ridge is seen running from the lingual cusp tip to the cervical line. The lingual root is smooth and tapering, and some part of the buccal root is also visible from this aspect. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form of the crown from the mesial aspect is trapezoidal, but unlike the buccal aspect, the longer parallel side is towards the cervix and the shorter side is towards the cusp. Both the buccal cusp and lingual cusp are visible. The lingual cusp is slightly smaller, around 1 to 2 mm than the buccal cusp. The tip of the cusps is within the confines of the root trunk. This is an important difference from the mandibular premolars, as the lingual cusp in them is outside the confines of the root. The buccal triangular ridge and lingual triangular ridge are seen running from the buccal and lingual cusp tip to the center of the occlusal surface. The buccal outline is convex and the maximum convexity or height of contour is at the junction of middle and cervical third. The lingual outline is also convex and the height of contour is at the middle third. The horizontal mesial marginal ridge is at the junction of occlusal and middle third. A developmental groove is seen on the mesial marginal ridge called the mesial marginal developmental groove. But this is only a part of the groove as rest of the groove is seen from the occlusal aspect. The cervical line is convex and the convexity is towards the crown. The buccal and lingual outline of the roots are straight in the cervical 2/3 and curved in the apical 1/3. The root trunk bifurcates into buccal root and lingual root at middle of the middle third. A deep concavity called the mesial developmental depression is seen on the mesial surface along the long axis of the tooth. It starts on the crown just cervical to the contact area, crosses the cervical line and ends at the bifurcation. Coming to the distal aspect, the distal aspect is same as the mesial aspect except for two differences. No developmental groove is seen on the distal marginal ridge. No developmental depression is seen running along the long axis of the tooth. Lastly, the occlusal aspect. The outline form of the crown from the occlusal aspect is hexagonal. The buccolingual dimension is greater than the mesiodistal dimension. Since the lingual cusp is smaller, the mesiodistal dimension is greater on the buccal side than the lingual side. Both buccal cusp and lingual cusp are seen. The buccal cusp appears nearer to the center of the crown than the lingual cusp. A number of ridges are present on the occlusal surface. Two triangular ridges, buccal triangular ridge running from the buccal cusp tip towards the center and lingual triangular ridge running from the lingual cusp tip towards the center. Four cuspal ridges, two for each cusp. Mesiobuccal cuspal ridge and distobuccal cuspal ridge running in proximal direction from the buccal cusp. Mesiolingual cuspal ridge and distolingual cuspal ridge running in proximal direction from the lingual cusp. Two marginal ridges, mesial marginal ridge running along the mesial outline and distal marginal ridge running along the distal outline. Two triangular concavities are seen just adjacent to the marginal ridges called the mesial triangular fossa and distal triangular fossa. The base of the triangle is towards the ridges and apex towards the center. A central sulcus runs mesiodistally joining the two triangular fossa. Two developmental pits are located at the bottom of these triangular fossa. Mesial developmental pit in the mesial triangular fossa and distal developmental pit in the distal triangular fossa. All four developmental grooves are seen from this aspect. A central developmental groove which runs mesiodistally at the bottom of the central sulcus from mesial pit to the distal pit. A mesiobuccal developmental groove running buccally from the mesial pit and a distobuccal developmental groove running buccally from the distal pit. The occlusal part of the mesial marginal developmental groove is also seen originating from the mesial pit and running across the mesial marginal ridge. Rest of the occlusal surface is smooth with no supplemental grooves. Few clinical considerations. Dense evaginatus is a developmental anomaly where an extra tubercle is seen between the buccal and lingual cusp. It is commonly seen in premolars and thus is also known as Leong's premolar. In anterior crowding of teeth, maxillary first premolar is the most common tooth extracted to create space in maxillary arch for orthodontic treatment.